This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. We're going to be evaluating trig functions with a calculator in this video. So for instance, we might do something like the cosine of 14 degrees. So if I wanted to enter 14 degrees as the angle, I would have to make sure that the calculator knows I'm entering it in degrees. So usually there is a key, there's either a mode or a DRG key, and there might be some other key depending on what kind of calculator you have. But if you want to enter the angle in degrees, you've got to make sure you have set that in degree mode. If you're going to enter an angle in radians, you're going to set it to the radian mode. Now it may just say DEG, short for degrees, or RAD, short for radians. Again, depends on your calculator. But always set that you have it correctly, right, before you enter. Most calculators have a key for sine, cosine, and tangent. Now, most of the modern ones, you could just press like cosine and then the angle, and then it'll give you the answer. Some older ones, you might have to put the angle in first and then press cosine. So you have to know your calculator. So let's say we want the cosine of 4. Notice this is not 4 degrees, it's just 4, so I have to make sure that my calculator is in radian mode. So either press your mode or your DRG button or whatever it is on your calculator that gets you to that, and make sure you put it in the radian mode, you enter radian mode, and then you can press cosine and then 4. Now, if you want, you could put a parentheses around that 4, but it's not necessary if it's just a single number like this. All right, so the cosine of 4 rounded, my calculator gives me negative 0.6536. Now, you might think about what cosine of 4 means. Well, remember the cosine of pi, that would be 3.14. That would mean that if you had this angle here, that would be about 3.14, and it's more than that. So it's somewhere over in this quadrant, right? So that's where negative 4 is, somewhere over here in this quadrant. And so it makes sense that the cosine is negative there. Now let's do the cosine of 4 degrees. Check the mode on your calculator. Make sure you put it in degree mode. So change it to degree mode, and then put in 4, cosine of 4, and see what you get. And this is what I get, rounded, 0.9976 when I round it to 4 places after the decimal point. All right, let's do the next one. Sine of pi over 7. Okay, now this is not in degrees, so we have to put it in the radian mode again. So make sure you put it in radian mode, and then try that on your own. And I get 0.4339. Now pi over 7 is sort of small, so that's like, you know, a seventh of pi. So that makes sense. It's in quadrant 1, right? And the cosine of 4 degrees, by the way, where's 4 degrees? Just think about that for a second, approximately. It's a really tiny number here, right? Oops, I did that backwards. It's like really, really tiny. So the x value here is almost as big as r, right? If you think of that in the cosine's x over r. So it's a, x is almost as big as r, so it's a little less than 1, right? Because x is smaller. So it should make sense. This number, 0.9976, is positive and almost up to 1. All right, let's think about the tangent of negative 2.1. So where's that, by the way? Negative 2.1. Well, that's less than pi, so it's like we're coming, you know, somewhere over in the third quadrant someplace, right? So, see, the tangent should be positive there in the third quadrant. If you remember, all students take calculus. The tangent is positive in this quadrant. And so we're in radians because it doesn't say degrees. So you, again, make sure that you put your calculator in radian mode, and then also remember to put the negative sign. So you're going to take the tangent of negative 2.1 degrees, and let's see, when I round it, I get 1.7098. 8. And the last one is the tangent of negative 2.1 degrees. Where is that? Like, that's really tiny. Negative 2.1 degrees is, tiny. I mean, I can't draw it, right? And so this one will be a negative number. And it'll be y over x, right? So if you look at the y value divided by the x, it should be a pretty small number because y is tiny compared to x, right? A small number over a large number. So let's go ahead and plug that in to the calculator. And also it's going to be negative, right? Because the tangent's negative here. And put it in degree mode, plug in negative 2.1, tangent of negative 2.1, and I got negative 0.0367. So that seems reasonable, right? Looks like it should be negative, and it should be a really tiny number because the y value is tiny compared to the x value. All right, so this is how to find the trig functions for the sine and the cosine and the tangent. See part 2 if you want to see how to use your calculator to find the secant, the cosecant, and the cotangent. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.